Hello, welcome to this episode of Let's Talk Death. I'm Fran Solomon.
And I'm Andy McNeil.
And we're thrilled to be your host for these conversations. Let's Talk Death is brought to you by Heal Grief, a social support network creating community after someone has died. Everything we do is inspired by our core belief that no one should ever grieve alone.
Our goal with this program is to have a friendly chat with some amazing people so we can help normalize and educate our Heal Grief community. Our guest today is Kelly Pascuzzi. Kelly is an entrepreneur, philanthropist, mom, wife, and a life and business coach, helping people develop the leader within. Kelly works side by side with Bob Proctor, chairman of Proctor Gallagher Institute, as a leadership and management consultant to individuals and business teams everywhere. Kelly is also the co-producer of The Ravine, a film based on the best-selling book about unimaginable horror and tragedy and the role that hope plays in healing. Kelly, welcome. We are delighted to have you as a guest on our show.
Thank you, and I'm so excited to be joining with you guys today to have a conversation about such an important topic.
Yeah, so Kelly, we've read the book, and very candidly, Andy and I concur, it was filled with suspense. Can you tell our audience a bit about the book and the soon-to-be-released feature film?
Well, the book was, let me start back. My husband, Robert, and I felt a calling. It was really not an invitation, but a calling to develop this fictional story based in regards to a personal experience that my husband and I had gone through. And our hope, which I think that we are going to deliver, was to bring such a universal message to the world on hope and forgiveness.
Wow. So fiction comes from many sources. Having said that, one of the things that we really were struck by was how you develop the characters to be so accurately portraying the true grief experience. So were these based on personal experiences? How did these actors have such a grasp of that experience of grief?
Well, it was really a collaboration, and I really feel that the right cast was attracted to this project. It was extremely a special project, and a lot of the cast had even mentioned to us that they felt called to do this film, even though they really couldn't put their finger on to why it is, but they responded because they knew they had to be a part of this project. But I think a lot of it was pretty incredible based on our ability to share a personal experience of our own emotion, and it was real and it was raw, and the actors were willing to go there with us just to develop these characters so the audience could really experience what grief looks like in a real life way.
Yeah, I really think I did find it very compelling, and the characters, again, just well defined as far as realistic in their grief experience. I've spent a lot of time sat with many families over the years, and this film and book really captures that. I wonder if you could talk a little bit about the subject matter of the movie being certainly just unimaginable tragedy, and the intensity of that, and talk a little bit about, I know you don't want to give away a lot in the book or the movie, but talk a little bit about hope in the midst of circumstances like that, and how that hope might be found in the midst of tragedy or difficult times.
Well, I will say that the material around the film is very heavy. It's certainly shocking at some times, and it's uncomfortable at times. And it brings up a lot of areas that most people don't want to talk about or even experience. But there's a lot of suspense to the film. One of the, I think, really challenging messages is, you know, we can't always control our external circumstances, but how we respond and the meaning we attach to those, we can control. It gives the audience an opportunity to really maybe embark on a journey and start to discover within themselves some particular situation that maybe they are dealing with now. Maybe they've had a tragedy or some form of experience that in the past that they've kind of compartmentalized and just left it there because they weren't ready to face it or deal with it. But our hope with this film is that, again, someone would embark on a journey that possibly could lead them to a space of forgiveness that they never thought they could have went on until they had possibly seen this film.
Wow.
One thing that I would like to add to that, yeah. I think even in my own personal experience, I held on to the scripture in Romans where it says everything will be used for good. And it's hard to go there and it's hard to hold on and believe in that, but there is always hope in those words, because if someone would have ever shared that years later, we would be looking at this film as the good, because this message I know is universal and it's going to impact and change millions of people's lives. That definitely is for good. But at the time, I wouldn't have believed it. So I really stayed with that biblical promise, and this film is actually the physical representation of that promise.
Yeah. Wow. It very much, to me, it shows the whole idea that that hope is even something that's accessible to us, even while we're going through the tragedy. It's just so often that we're not either connected to it or tapped into it, or even willing at that point, maybe even don't even have the energy even to begin to think about how our own thoughts about the situation and how our choices about how we go through that situation are either making our situation worse or even better. You know, it's hard to make that connection sometimes when you're so drained by your own grief, you know, quite often.
I did find, and it's really incredible what you shared, because it's true. It's the feeling of being completely empty and drained and you feel hopeless, but there is always resources available. And some of those times, you know, ideas, people, resources are placed on your path when you are not even expecting, but they are there to help. I know we personally, Robert and I, had someone that had reached out at a time that I really needed guidance, and I needed a reminder that there is light at the end of the darkness. And so maybe people would be more open and aware and just be willing. I think part of it was to be willing to ask for help, because this isn't anything, a journey that you'll ever be able to do on your own.
Yeah.
And that's an important message. In many of our conversations with individuals that have actually had their own grief experience, it really is in the support of others and in the understanding that the support of others can really be cathartic and help guide them through their own personal journey. That's so important. And I'd like to touch on that a little bit. So clearly you've had your own personal experience here, and not to go too deep in that, but was it really hope that led you to where you are today, or were there other things that you learned to cope with that helped you in your journey?
I think, you know, going back to, you know, holding on to that biblical message that there is good in this, but you have to look for it. Before I got to that space, I moved through space of anger. I moved through space of disbelief. I moved through space that I had conflict. Even, you know, my husband Robert was addressing and also experiencing or attaching a different meaning than I was. And so we were experiencing this loss in such a different way.
Interesting.
And so even though I think at times someone's trying to offer support, sometimes you're not ready to receive it. But I did stay with the thought that there has to be something good in here. And maybe it's the ability for me to forgive. I thought early on the idea of forgiveness was for myself, but I understood it was really, I'm sorry for the other, but it was really for myself to be able to let that go, to open a new space, to accept, you know, beauty, new life, new ideas, new feelings, love, forgiveness, all the above. And believe me, I didn't get there in a day. And even, you know, in regards to the film, during filming, it was like this situation in my life was front and center again. But, you know, I'm a different person now and there's a different meaning attached, but I'm still moving through that space. And it wasn't always easy to do that. But I think, you know, it, in the end, the idea of forgiveness with anything in your life, it really creates such a beautiful energy that you're able to invite and to share.
That's beautifully so beautifully said. And, you know, I've discovered the same thing. Forgiveness is important. And another aspect, which is interesting to me, and it's certainly the writing of the book and then producing this this film that will touch, you know, hundreds of thousands of lives, right? That when we give something like that, when we give forgiveness, we also find, you know, hope and healing and all of those things. But also when we give a gift like this, like that you're taking something, maybe a message and something that was learned in life and working it into a fictional story that's going to touch many lives, that in and of itself is also healing and hopeful to those who are creating that. You know, I think about the actors that, like you said, that they felt, you know, called to be part of this film, so that by giving this as a gift, there's also something that's gained in that. Not that that's the purpose for it, but there is a gain, somehow healing for ourselves.
Well, it's interesting because, you know, our intent, obviously the purpose is to share this universal message, to offer, you know, healing around the world. But like you said, I never even expected, even within the filming, I had a certain member of the cast approach us and say, thank you for this project. This project changed my life. I had not really paid attention, but I was really focusing on the dark in my life. And since the filming of this movie, I've really chosen to focus on the light, and it's really changing my life and those around me. And I mean, that was so incredible and fulfilling that there is so much good around us. We just have to look to find it.
Yeah.
So Kelly, the book is out, it's been out. And tell us about the, first off, I'm speculating, I'm assuming that the film is going to be very much based on the novel.
Yes, it is. I mean, there's a few alterations just because of obviously the time of the film, or the length of the film. You obviously cannot incorporate everything into the book, but pretty much it runs true to the story.
Great. And where are you in filming now? Where? When are we going to see it?
Well, right now we are in editing, and you know, as first-time producers here, I'm understanding how each stage is so important. And obviously, one of the ways a movie is made is in the editing room. So we have been going through and making cuts, and it's really coming together. We're getting super excited.
Great. Great.
Well, Kelly, we only have a few minutes left, and before we end the episode, I know that we have listeners who are going to connect with this, going to connect with what we've talked about. And they're going to want to connect with the book, with the movie, the film, with you all. How might they make that connection?
Well, if they'd like to follow at the Ravine Info, it's coming soon. And then also follow Kelly Pascuzzi on Facebook for sneak previews of the film.
Great, great. We're going to do that, and we'll have that posted up as well. Very exciting. So, Kelly, we want to thank you so much for being our guest here on Let's Talk Death and for sharing a bit about your story, but mostly about the novel and the film, which we're very excited to see the film. Very excited about that.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And I just want to commend you for the work that you're doing. It's so important, like you said, that no one grieves alone. And so many people out there, unfortunately, are grieving alone. And so this awareness around this, you know, idea that you're offering that you don't have to and you connect with others, it's such a beautiful thing. So we're so excited to be a part of it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. And we want to thank those who are joining us for this episode as well. If you would like to learn more about Heal Grief, please visit us at healgrief.org. At healgrief.org, you can learn more about all the programs and resources of Heal Grief, including our national network of support of grieving young adults. It's a program that we call Actively Moving Forward.
Make sure you sign up on healgrief.org to receive our newsletter for links to future episodes of Let's Talk Death.
So thank you for joining us, and we will see you next time on Let's Talk Death.